Hey loves, welcome back to my channel. My name is Adanna. So today's video, we're going to be discussing hair. Hair, and more hair. There's going to be quite a lot of vulnerability in this video, but I'm hoping it helps some of us. Y'all, do you ever just moisturize your hair and you just go out and you come back and it's dry?
So I will take you all through factors that has contributed to mine, having fixing it through my entire wash day routine.
First key factor you want to consider when it comes to your hair care regimen is your hair porosity. This basically explains the ability of your hair to absorb and retain moisture, which overall has to do with how close your hair cuticles are if you're low porosity and how open your hair cuticles are if you're high porosity.
Your hair porosity plays a huge role on what hair products you should be using that's going to be effective for your hair and what hair products you should avoid. And not taking note of this could also result in having dry hair because you're basically using the wrong product or even using the wrong hair regimen.
Y'all, these are stuffs I've learned over time, so now I'm sharing that with y'all so we can all learn together, you know? Couple ways you can determine the porosity of your hair. You can use the float test. However, you want to make sure that the strand of hair you're using for this entire float test is quite clean, just so you don't alter the results from this experiment. If your hair stays floating at the top of this water, then you most likely do have low porosity hair. And if it goes halfway through the glass, then you most likely do have normal porosity hair. If it sinks all the way down after 5 minutes, then you most likely do have high porosity hair. Also look at how your hair saturates in water. If it takes a while for water to all penetrate and, you know, absorb into your hair, then you most likely do have low porosity hair. Also, if you do tend to get product buildup like me, then you most likely do have low porosity hair. And if your hair also tends to take so long to dry, like your twist outs, your braid outs, then you also most likely do have low porosity hair. But now that we've kind of figured out that entire aspect, we're going to go ahead right now to move on to wash day. I took my natural hair down from a 3.5 week old protective hairstyle. This was the butterfly locks I just took down. So in this scenario, I have to go ahead to make sure that I'm deeply cleansing my hair to take away all and every product build up. Normally I use apple cider vinegar shampoo if I do have any. However, on the days that I don't have any, like today, I just went ahead to use my regular tea tree shampoo, which I picked up from Winners. And then since that is quite moisturizing and I actually want to cleanse my hair, I normally go ahead to do a quick apple cider vinegar rinse. This is half apple cider vinegar and half water. This is going to help to break down all of that product build ups, dandruff, all of that. Apple cider vinegar just cleanses and deeply cleanses your hair and your scalp. Moving on to deep condition. This is the favorite and the most exciting part of wash day. I'm going to be using the natural deep conditioner. This one has jojoba and monoi oil, which is great for low porosity hair. These are lightweight oils and they tend to easily penetrate into our hair. One of the major things that changed my life for my winter hair care routine in this dry climate environment that I do live in Alberta, is avoiding conditioners that do have a high amount of humectants. So humectants are products or ingredients that draw moisture from the atmosphere. These are ingredients such as glycerin, honey, sorbitol, sorbic acid, and there are a lot of them. But glycerin and honey are one of the most powerful humectants that draws moisture from the atmosphere. During summer season, when the weather is quite humid, humectants are great because they're able to draw moisture from the atmosphere to my natural hair. However, during winter season where I do live in, the weather here is very dry. So instead of humectants drawing moisture from the atmosphere to my hair is drawing moisture to the atmosphere. So it's just a no. Knowing this has definitely helped me a lot because before, I will literally moisturize my hair and once I just go out and come back, my hair will just be doing crrr, crrr, crrr. I'm sure this hair was very juicy before I left this house. So this was the time I sat down and I started reading about every single ingredient in my hair products that I was using. So now that we're done deep conditioning our natural hair in sections, low porosity hair loves heat. Heat is just the best way to get products to just, you know, just suck in. So now that we're done deep conditioning everything in warm water, because you guys saw I was in warm water this entire time, we're going to go ahead right now to put on a heating cap. We'll leave this on for 30 minutes while we can chill. You want to make sure you're staying hydrated because your outside product is a reflection of your inside product. So we're going to drink some water while we catch some break. At this point, this is where I normally just stretch my leg. If I'm making hot jollof rice and chicken, this is where I just go and steam my chicken and prepare my tomatoes for my jollof rice. But today we're going to be productive while completing some surveys and sharing with you guys about our sponsor of today's video, Opinion Outpost. With Opinion Outpost, you're able to complete surveys that allows you to redeem points. You could use these points to redeem a gift card, or you could also use these points to redeem money. Having tried Opinion Outpost is definitely a great and easy way to make some extra cash while just chilling at home, watching TV, in the toilet, anywhere you are. It's also free to sign up, so definitely click the link down below in the description box to start making some extra cash that we could use towards our next hairstyle, next hair extensions, our next hair jewelries, you know, that extra savings on the side. Now, our 30 minutes break is up. Our hair feels so good right now. The deep conditioner is sitting. You know that feeling of warmth when you just come out of deep conditioning your hair? It's just, it's unexplainable. And then right now, I'll just go ahead to wash off this deep conditioner. I feel like sometimes the deep conditioner kind of like hides in this little twist that we have going on here. So sometimes I have to unravel the twist to rinse out all of that deep conditioner. So right now, moving on to moisturizing. For my leave-in conditioner, I'm using the Kinky Curly Knot today. Y'all, this has no glycerin. It has no humectant. Like, when I found this leave-in conditioner, I was so happy. It's definitely a great add-on to my winter hair care products. Also, if you do experience that your hair tends to get dry so easily, y'all, check out the, like, be more cautious of the climate that you live in, and also check the ingredients in your hair products. It could be just that one ingredient that could be causing havoc, okay? So check all of that. So while I'm in the shower and my cuticle is all open from all the heat, from the shower, hot water, everything, I just went ahead right now to apply my leave-in conditioner in the shower in sections. This just allows this leave-in conditioner to penetrate in. It just allows everything to get in and the moisture is just seeping in properly. And then once I'm done with all of that leave-in conditioner, I just went ahead to put on my shower cap. I had the shower cap on for as long as I went ahead to take a shower, do all of that stuff, you know, get ready. And then right now, I'm just going to go ahead to seal in all of that moisture. To seal in all of that moisture, I'm just going to go ahead to use my shea butter mix. Yo, this entire shea butter mix is very simple. I had this raw shea butter that I got from King Folk. This is from my girl Naturally Philo on Instagram. And then as an emollient, I just went ahead to add argan oil. You can use any lightweight oil that works for you. You could use jojoba oil, you could use olive oil, you could use coconut oil, but argan oil works perfectly fine for me. And it's also great for low porosity hair because it's lightweight and it's just going to easily penetrate into my hair shafts. Once it was all buttery, I just used a spoon to mix it. I don't have any of those fancy blenders, so I just used a spoon to mix it. And once it was all buttery and the consistency was, you know, fine enough, I just went ahead to apply this to my hair right now in sections while my hair is still damp from the entire shower routine. And then for my scalp, I went ahead to use my Edding Body Works Peppermint and Tea Tree Oil. This is going to help to avoid dry and flaky scalp, dandruff, and all of that. So I went ahead to spritz this all over my scalp and massage this into my scalp as well. And then after I was done with this entire moisturizing routine, you all, this was basically all I did. And then you can go ahead to style your hair into any fancy hairstyle if you would like. My hair is going to take a while for it to dry. You know the entire low porosity. So it's going to take a while for it to dry. So you'll see my hair is looking a little bit white, but don't worry, it's going to dry. But that's basically it for this video, you all. Let me know down below in the comment section if this video was helpful. And if you do have any tips for your girl hair, I would love and appreciate it because I always love to learn more from y'all. So let me know down below in the comment section if you have more tips for low porosity hair girls, or even high porosity or normal porosity. We are all here to learn. I hope you all enjoyed this video. Thumbs up if you did, comments, share, subscribe, and I will see you all in my next one. Have a wonderful day. Bye. Love y'all.
my feeling, no my vibe and see the girl them go down. Ooh, we at the show now.